Tommy. My name is Miss Gina. I'm one of the preschool teachers at Adventure Club Preschool. And today I wanted to share with you guys some quick Mother's Day crafts. So if you're a mom, let's go ahead and give your computer or your phone to your significant other or an older child or sister, aunt, uncle, whoever. Somebody else, just look away and don't watch, okay? So I have three crafts today, starting out a little easy for the younger kids, getting a little bit harder. Let's go ahead and dive in. So my first craft is super simple. This should be pretty easy for toddlers or 2-3-year-olds, anybody that wants to do it can have fun doing it and shouldn't have too much trouble. You're only going to need a couple items. We have a piece of cardstock. I have white, you can do it blue, you can do it any color you want. It doesn't need to be cardstock, it can be construction paper, regular printer paper, whatever paper you have available. And then we're going to use some forks. I have a paintbrush, but again, that's something you can use a marker instead if you don't have a paintbrush. And then just some washable tempera paint. So this is what our craft is going to look like. They're just little fork-shaped tulips. And I just wrote, I love you, across the top of this one. You can add a little border on it, fold it, make it a card, put the little flowers, whatever you want. So all this is going to take, so simple. Check it out. Take your fork, dip it in, and then you're just going to lay it down and roll it out. That's it. I only had red and blue and green, so I have red, blue, and purple tulips for this project. So once you have all your tulips on your paper, I'm just gonna do this here real quick. I'm just laying it down and rolling it out. Then we're gonna take our green, and again, you can do this with a green marker. And we're just going to add some swirls with stems. And then we're going to take a marker. You know, in hindsight, you should probably do this part beforehand, but it's okay. We'll make it work. And we're just going to write Happy Mother's Day. And then the most important part will be signing it and putting a date on it. Don't forget that part. And so, super simple, nice and fun, very cute. Mom will love it. Okay, and so for our second craft, this one's just a little bit harder, but still pretty easy with some help. Almost anybody could do it. This one is just this cute little I Love Mom Because flower. And all we need for this one is gonna be some paper, whether it's white paper, construction paper, cardstock, colored paper, whatever kind of paper you wanna use. We're gonna need scissors, glue, and markers. Super simple, hopefully something that everybody has around their house. I already kinda have it all prepped here for this. We're gonna cut circle and some petals. Then what we're going to do with our petals, we're going to go ahead and write on them now. We're going to write any reason you love mom, any reason you want to write at all. So on this one we'll put, she takes care of me. Okay, and you can do stickers, you can do hearts, flowers, draw pictures, whatever you would like. Then we're going to take our glue stick or glue. You can use stapler, you can use tape, whatever you have handy. And we're going to glue on the part that we wrote on the same side. And just glue that on top and work ourselves all the way around. then again, the most important part of this, after you fill out all of your little petals about why you love your mom, is signing the back. Make sure to put your name and the date. At least write 2020. Okay, and that's our second craft. Third craft is a little bit harder, but it's a little bit more unique. It is kind of fun. What we're going to do here is we're going to make this little watercolor card in a matching mark. What we're going to need for these is the piece of cardstock that I don't have. Again, you can use construction paper, cardstock, regular printer paper, wart, whatever you have available. Then after we got our paper, we're going to need some watercolors, a cup of water, a white crayon or oil pastel, and then a pair of scissors, and then a couple optional things. You're going to need a hole punch or a pencil or anything you could poke a hole with, a knife, whatever works. Ribbons or strings, and some packing tape. On this one, we're going to start out with a mat that I've been using for this. Mom will thank you, trust me. I also have some paper towel here. You can add optional glitter, stickers, whatever kind of embellishments, some beadwork on the strings, whatever kind of embellishments you want to make it pretty. Start with our paper on the mat, and that's pretty important on this one. You're going to get it pretty wet, okay? And then we're going to fold it, but we're not going to fold it all the way. We're only going to fold it so there's just a little bit left there for your bookmark. So this will be your card, this will be your bookmark. Okay, so you're going to go ahead and fold that. Okay, and if you want to, you can tape it down to your mat, that way it doesn't move. Then we're going to take our oil pastel or our crayon, and we're going to write on it. We're going to write, I love. Make sure you're pressing pretty hard, especially if you're using crayon. Make sure it's really on there. Okay, and then we're going to write some, draw some hearts on the bookmark. The preschoolers is I like to get it really wet for them to make it kind of really super simple. I don't want to just like run all over and all the colors to mix them, so I use a little spray bottle. Get it really good and wet. Especially for the younger juniors and toddlers, this trick helps a lot. Okay, and then paper towel here so we don't make any mess. And then we're going to take our brush. The biggest trick to this that I found testing it out is going to be less water, more paint. So you want to get a lot of paint on your brush. Okay. Swirl it around, get lots of paint on there, and then we're just going to gently go across. You can do it in blobs, you can do it in circles, you can do however is working out best for you. We're just gonna kinda go across like this. Rinse it off really good. Less water, more paint. Go across. However is working out for you. Thank you. our final project. Okay, and then what we're gonna do is we're gonna go ahead and cut that part off once it dries. I'm gonna get down, but I recommend waiting until it's all dry. Luckily with watercolors, it'll dry pretty quick. So the card is actually done right there. You can sign the back, of course, the most important part. And draw stickers, draw pictures, put stickers on there, draw a picture, whatever you would like to do with it inside. And then as far for the bookmark, we do need to wait until this one dries. So what we would do is we would take it. I put a strip of tape on each side, which is optional, it's just to make it last longer. Tie a string on through the top, punch a hole with your hole puncher, use a knife, use a pencil, whatever works. Tie your strings, your ribbon, whatever you have available to decorate the top, and of course, then move back. And there you have it, your matching bookmark and your card. She's going to love. Happy Mother's Day, everybody. Have a great one. Bye.